A few weeks back, we first brought you the story of Matthew Ng, a Chinese-born Australian businessman currently held in a Chinese prison. He was sentenced for embezzlement, corruption and bribery, and then he lost his final appeal. The family maintains he is completely innocent and has fallen victim to corrupt local officials. Matthew's wife cares for the four children and has been suffering breast cancer as well. She's granted us her first television interview. We've agreed not to reveal her full identity, as there are still some concerns for her safety.
I feel very sorry because I'm helpless. I can't do anything because this is the final outcome, and he has to bear with it until, you know, there is a change to end this nightmare.
Matthew Ng's wife has not spoken on television before. She's afraid, even now, of being identified. Her husband, Matthew, a 45-year-old Australian citizen, is held in a Chinese prison. He became embroiled in a commercial dispute with interests of the Communist Party. It landed him an 11-and-a-half-year sentence.
But I hope the Australian government could do more to bring him back here.
This is the most recent picture of Matthew Ng taken on a prison visit. In a series of transactions from his company, ET China, bought from the Communist Party Lingnan Group, a controlling interest in a travel company called GZL. Lingnan decided it wanted its share back at the original price, and that's where the deal went sour.
You've been to visit Matthew in prison. What's his mental state like?
He is totally blank. Totally, don't know what he's doing, what he's supposed to do. Like writing a simple letter, an application, he can't do it. He said he cannot do it.
How do you think he's being treated there in the prison?
I don't know, but from the way he kept crying, I know he's very sad and distressed. He said he sleeps on the floor, there's no bed.
These are very serious charges against Matthew: embezzlement, corruption. And they did find him guilty.
Yes, it is.
And he has gone through a court process.
Yes, a very long battle. He stood for his right. But in the end, the outcome is very bad. Very bad for all of us. Not only him, but also to the family.
He has gone through a court case. He has been found guilty. Do you think it's possible that he is guilty of these things?
No, I don't think he is guilty, because all these are all commercial, very simple commercial dispute, and they make it like they make it as a criminal convictions. The stress is unimaginable.
And you've had breast cancer as well?
Yeah.
Just to complicate things?
Yeah.
Do you feel angry?
Of course, I do feel angry, because this is a nightmare. And this is what we get. Of course, I'm angry. This is the outcome of staying there, doing business in China.
Well, we saw a reaction from the federal government tonight. In a statement from Bob Carr's office, it has confirmed that Matthew has requested to be transferred to Australia, but the status of his application, in their words, cannot be disclosed. They've also said, "We have raised this issue with the Chinese foreign minister on a number of occasions. Minister Carr did this personally in May. We're not in a position to challenge or overturn the Chinese court's decision."